PDX. We fucking love you. So, this is how much we love you. I have a broken foot pending surgery right now. I wasn't supposed to fly, but I'm here today. So forgive the stool. This might look like I'm trying to be like Mick Jagger or something, but it's really a glorified cane.
Got it, dude.
Was anybody here last time we played in this town? So thank you for fucking joining us again. Those of you who are new, our band is called Race Trader, and that's what we're about. We're here with a really good friend, Sonny. He does a, you know, a little platform called Hate 5-6. Have you heard of it? And Sonny does this little segment with bands where you read the hateful comments about you, and then we gotta react to them. It's like Jimmy Kimmel but punk rock. And a band that takes this position in this day and age, with the type of internet trolls we get, we get some very interesting comments. We don't get like, these guys aren't hard. We get like, oh, these guys are an instrument of the deep state. And we get my name a lot in triple parentheses, if you know what that means. And one thing that comes up with all these sort of alt-right comments under our videos over and over and over again is references to, you know, Muslims with a secret agenda, and this really hateful Islamophobic thing. And for us, because that's the background I do come from, you know, that shit is pretty serious. Because a lot of people in hardcore firmly believe they're anti-racists, and they really have that conviction. And we know there's people in this room today that are fucking fighting Nazis in the streets. We salute you. But the alt-right has something that they like to use in this room. Because a lot of us are agnostic, atheist, anti-religion for very good reasons. But they like to turn that into a bit of Islamophobia as a gateway drug to the larger fucking ideology of fucking ethno-religious capitalist fascism.
Fuck Dawkins!
Exactly. Fuck Dawkins and like fuck people like Sam Harris. Many of my parents love him. But that guy, nice to sound really fucking smart and intelligent, and he talks about all sorts of things, and then he slips in ridiculous fucking fear tactics about Muslims and Islam. No one's saying that elements of the Muslim world are beyond critique. The religion is beyond critique. But that's not what motherfuckers like Sam Harris are about. He's about fucking stoking fear. And surprise, surprise, he then comes out and says, hey, guess what? I think black people are intellectually inferior to white people, and genetics proves it. So these motherfuckers come to you like they're on your fucking side. And they feed you things that you want to hear. Deep state, yeah, that makes sense. Fuck the government. And then they rope you in. And what I'm asking everybody in this room is, fucking talk to each other and don't fall for that bullshit.
Yeah.
War. To me, that's a very important band. You know, we just crossed the border from Canada. We played in Vancouver. It was a fucking great show. We come over, then we have the privilege to come back to this country, play another great show in front of all of you. And it got me thinking, you know, like, here we are, we're fucking crossing this border. And at the fucking bottom of this country, there's tens of thousands of people. They are fleeing violence, threats to their life, sexual discrimination, death threats from the cartels, death threats from the fucking governments, in poverty, generational poverty. And we want to talk about fucking keeping them out. I get to fucking go back and forth across the border, but we want to talk about keeping them out. And those people are from Honduras, Guatemala, El Salvador. Many of them are indigenous themselves. And us, living on stolen fucking land, think we get the right to build gates and decide who comes in and comes out. Yeah. And the thing is, this is personal to me. My parents immigrated from a country, Iran, to the United States, in a time of political instability. And now, this dumb fuck in the White House is instilling laws to block people from the country that I came from, that my parents came from coming here. Meaning that I wouldn't be with you folks if I was born in a different generation. We wouldn't be having this conversation.
Open borders!
Open no fucking borders, fuck human border. Fucking rights, abolish ICE, fuck the wall, stand in solidarity with immigrants, stand in front of xenophobia.
Thank you.
got some shit. Still got some shit.
I know.
Look, we fucking love Wicked Humanity. They understand that this is fucking cultural resistance that we're doing here. And they brought us on, they talked us into playing this show, and we thank them for that. They're our brothers. We got their backs in the air. Nathan Zababa was the second person to ask Race Trainer to play a show after we reunited. Now, he turned his ass down, but we're infinitely grateful for him and honored to be playing with those dudes tonight. At the heart of the world, we're pretty fucking brutal. I don't understand where the drums went, but it was fucking sick. So shout outs to them. Emma and Against the Grain, we love you, thank you. Have her back, she'll have yours. You know, we all have a choice, and that's whether or not we're gonna be part of the solution or part of the problem. Usually, I'm talking about myself here. I choose the wrong answer. I choose to stay home, play it safe. But those moments of bravery that I can summon, I feel are valuable to me and hopefully to others. I implore every single one of you, these politics are not a fucking t-shirt. They're not a fucking song. They're not a scene. They belong outside. When immigrants are attacked, you're in front of fucking ICE. When the fascists march, you fucking lock arms against them. When women are attacked and threatened, you listen to them and you do what they fucking say.